Hello everyone, Wayne from the CERN and Earth and Space Center here. In today's video, we're going to be taking another look at some of the stories in the stars. And this time, we're going to focus on Ursa Major and Ursa Minor, or the Big and Little Bears. It's one of my favorite stories in the sky. So without any further ado, let's jump on in and take a look at the two bears. So here we are, standing in front of the CERN and Earth and Space Center at Triton College in River Grove. We have our date set to April 9th and our time set to 9 o'clock at night, which is just around 2 hours after the sun sets. This is a great time to go out and take a look at the sky because it'll be nice and dark and you'll be able to see what you're looking for. Now, we're facing towards the west, looking at the CERN and Earth and Space Center, but we're looking for Ursa Major and Ursa Minor in the sky. And to find those, we need to turn towards the north. So we'll turn around here, and we'll see, as we look higher up in the sky, that we can find our Big Dipper almost directly overhead, very high up in the sky, and that makes up part of Ursa Major, the Great Bear. And then we can use the Big Dipper to point our way towards that north star, and that'll bring us to find Ursa Minor, or the Little Bear in the sky. Now, these come from ancient Greek and Roman astronomy, which many of the shapes that we see in the sky come from those mythologies, and they have a rather interesting story. Now, the story about these bears is, well, they don't really look quite like bears. They have these long tails, and we all know that bears have short little stubby tails, but there is a reason that these two bears have those long tails. Now, the short version of the story is that they wanted to put the bears up into the sky so that they could live there forever, but they weren't quite sure how to get them up there. So they found the biggest and strongest person they could find, who happened to be Zeus, king of the gods, and he decided to grab those bears by their stubby little bear tails, swing them around in a circle really, really fast, and when they were going fast enough, they let go and threw the bears up into the sky. But while Zeus was swinging them around like that, their tails got all stretched out, and that's why these two bears have those long tails. Now, the reason they were putting them up into the sky was a little bit less happy than just stretching out their tails. What happened was Ursa Major, the big bear, was a woman that Zeus was in love with, and Zeus's wife got jealous, turned her into a bear. Her son was a hunter and was about to shoot her with a bow and arrow, but Zeus saw this and decided to fix everything by turning the son into a bear as well, who he turned into Ursa Minor, or the Little Bear, and then put them both up into the sky, stretching out their tails so that they could live there forever and hide away from the jealous Hera, queen of the gods. Now, these come from ancient Greek mythology, but we do know that many cultures across the world used these stars specifically to travel around, navigate, and also tell their stories. Now, the reason we know that is because Ursa Minor has Polaris, the North Star, which is a very important star to us, helps us point our way towards the north, and we know many of the shapes that come around those. So let's go through a few of those and see what other kind of cultures saw in the sky when looking at Ursa Major and Ursa Minor. Arabic cultures looked up into the sky and saw rather similar shapes. They saw what they called the Greater Bear and the Lesser Bear. And again, they have those strange long tails. Probably a very similar story to their creation. Now, the Belarusians looked up into the sky and they didn't see bears, but rather they saw wagons or chariots. They saw Elias's cart being carried by a horse and what they called the nail, which was part of the small cart, which we can see in the sky, and they're all kind of connected together. So they had a large cart and a small cart being drawn by horses through the sky. Many cultures grouped the Big Dipper and the Little Dipper, or the Big Bear and Little Bear, together as related constellations in the sky, but the Inuit people did not. They used only the Big Dipper, and they saw it as the caribou, what we can see here, where the spoon of what we would know as the dipper was the body, and then the handle formed the neck and head of the caribou. And finally, the Ojibwe Native American tribe used the Big and Little Dippers as well, and they saw some fantastic pictures. They saw the Big Dipper, as most of the Big Bear as well, as what they called the fisher, which is like a type of weasel, a very ferocious type of weasel that is great at catching fish. And they saw the Little Dipper as the loon in the sky. Both of these are water-based animals, a very water-based tribe. And these are what they saw, was some fantastic pictures here in Stellarium to show us these. Well, thank you everyone for learning about Ursa Major and Ursa Minor with me today. Again, my name is Wayne from the CERN and Earth and Space Center at Triton College in River Grove. Remember, you can make up whatever stories you want to in the sky. All you have to do is use your imagination. And the best way for you to do that is to get out there and take a look at your night skies.